Hi colleagues, thank you very much for having me in this course. It's my pleasure to be here and share with you our Bolivian experience around the process of coming up with a multidimensional poverty index. I'm giving you greetings from La Paz, Bolivia, where I sit. I am the res rep for UNDP Bolivia, and I would like to share with you a few lessons learned. Also a few anecdotes, perhaps, on how we went about this very complex process in the country and where we stand right now in terms of adopting this metric. The process of the multidimensional poverty index in Bolivia goes back to 2018, where we had a memorandum of understanding agreed upon with the government through the Ministry of Planning. And this was an interesting achievement back in the day, because the history of MPI and poverty measurement in Bolivia goes back to the 90s, and UNDP's role in this measurement was also very prominent back in the day. But it was really tough for UNDP to do the policy sort of influencing and working around the notion of needing to integrate other dimensions in poverty measurement. What we did was working through different policy angles to bring the idea and the 2016 regional human development report helped a lot. The notion of going beyond income helped us to position this discourse, this new narrative with government, and to initiate our work in this regard. And it soon became really evident the need to have a multidimensional metric for measuring human development and other sort of integral ways of dealing with this at the national and also subnational level, and I'm going to talk about that in a few minutes. Right now, we are at a point where Bolivia aspires to be the 11th country in the region having an MPI. We've been working for the last year and a half in getting a national calculation for the MPI. This was done in coordination with OFI, University of Oxford, and chiefly with our colleagues in the UNDP LAC Panama Hub, who were really instrumental in helping us to implement the whole process around this calculation. We've been working from the government side. It has been critical to achieve very strong technical, not only political, but also technical partnerships with the unit of social and economic policy analysis, and also the National Institute of Statistics. As you know, many of the databases and the information we need to run these sort of calculations require an open access to the formal databases, particularly household surveys that the Institute of Statistics administers and runs. So we began through the signature of a memorandum of understanding, and through this MOU we managed to establish a work plan. And this work plan basically included all the actors across the board that I mentioned just a minute ago, including all the technical staff in these units in the Ministry of Development Planning, and our team, the human development team within the country office. And this unleashed a very interesting process from a technical point of view. We started by doing desk work and technical analysis, reviewing the databases, reviewing the constraints we had in terms of data points, deciding what sort of indicators, what sort of dimensions could be fed into the methodology, the MPI methodology. Also, we moved into a very, very interesting process, which will give us a lot of iterations in terms of our work down the line as UNDP with the validation process. We had six technical sessions, and we had nine regional meetings with the different policymakers, academia, civil society, local authorities in all nine departments across the country to gauge their interest, but also to get their views on the way we were going around about the measurement. And of course, the technical work that OFI and particularly UNDP LAC sponsored for us, and this was, I think, the main sort of quality control, quality assurance, but also the technical work, which including the included the robustness tests and also the mirror calculations. And here I must say that being a global organization and having a local presence, this is exactly where that sort of architecture as UNDP, it really pays off, because we can tap into the best minds within the organization that can help us to secure from a global perspective and based on comparative experiences how to go about our own calculations for Bolivia. There were, as I said, a few milestones. These milestones, from my perspective, there are several anecdotes. We had all this process happened amidst an extremely critical political crisis in Bolivia. As you know, there were cancelled elections in October 2019, and we were in the middle of this process. So it was really challenging for our colleagues to travel around the country to run these working sessions and validation sessions with all the actors. But at the same time, while that was a not such a funny anecdote, but that was an interesting part of the process, that also put in very strong evidence that we more than ever need to have these kinds of spaces, reflection spaces to look into policy making in a much more integral and inclusive way. And this was a very good learning process for my team in UNDP Bolivia, but also for our partners as well, who really were very much committed to coming up with the process. The MPI looks back to 2011, and we have seven dimensions decided with a number of indicators within each of them. And a couple of months ago, before COVID-19 and this huge crisis that is really throwing us into very uncertain times, for sure, in the case of Bolivia, we had a technical session working with a new minister to validate the final results and to require sort of the political conclusion, the political cycle, right, that needs to go into this. What we are seeing is, of course, we are right now in a transition period in Bolivia, and we have a transition government. Therefore, we are working with government to make sure that we have certainty from the part of UNDP that the calculations were well done. But on the other hand, we also need to be mindful and acknowledge that Bolivia is transitioning politically, and therefore we will have a validation in due course when a new government comes in place. What came up in the middle of this national MPI process, in the construction of the national indicator, is the interest from one of the departments coming from Tarija. The department of Tarija was very much into this discussion, and we were in a way summoned to go south and discuss with them what this MPI was about and how to help them construct a subnational MPI to help them better target their resources and better target the policy making for vulnerable groups. The process for Tarija was super interesting, and actually we were able to certify the first ever subnational MPI for in the Latin American and Caribbean region. That was done back in January 2020, and we are extremely, extremely proud of the way the government, the subnational government, managed to allocate resources, but also to allocate political will to get this moving. So this is one of the better examples, I think, in Bolivia, where we had good alignment between the national process and a subnational process, and the type of results we can achieve in all. Finally, as a reflection, looking back into 2019, which was also the year where Bolivia adopted the MAPS mission and their MAPS report, this has proven to be a very interesting exercise to align the sort of accelerators and policy areas that have been prioritized with in the context of the report. In that regard, we will be able through MPI to help Bolivia identify what are the indicators that need to be strengthened in terms of measurement of these accelerators that were identified in the region vis-a-vis the different regions in Bolivia vis-a-vis the MAPS report. And this is a good example in a way of how alignment can happen. You know, what I guess I'm trying to say is that MPI can be one of the tools, one of the mechanisms with which Bolivia can follow through in the implementation of its MAPS accelerators. With that, I will leave it here. I hope that you follow our progress. We will be adopting and implementing MPI also in the COVID-19 response. This has proven to be an interesting tool for UDAPE, for INE, and for the ministry in general to look into targeting mechanisms to allocate different social subsidies in the context of the response. And I wish you all a very successful course, and I hope we will see each other soon through all these wonderful interactions of MPI. Thank you.